As you know that in our last class, we started with this chapter number one, that is Introduction of Settlement Geography. Yesterday I gave you my basic references, including books by Sumana Ghosh, YVP Sinha, SD Maurya, and my own FY textbook. Then we started discussing this first topic 1.1, that is settlement geography, definition, nature, and scope. Now, in that, we did a brief introduction to how settlements evolve. And so we started our discussion with the wandering humans, so how humans were wandering from place to place and they were involved in hunting and gathering. They use natural shelters, so existing caves or branches of the trees as their dwelling places. And the basic purpose was to protect themselves from natural extremities as well as from wild animals and other human attacks. So that was the basic purpose. And then we have seen some pictures of some natural caves. I referred to these cave drawings or cave paintings of the prehistoric man and some representative diagrams. And then we said that evolution of agriculture, the knowledge that that humans that we can produce our own food. And we did not depend entirely on nature itself, but we can, I mean, the entire production of food comes under our control. Now, the beginning of this particular process was made at around 10,000 years ago, and gradually agriculture went on evolving, and along with that, even house as a structure emerged. I told you yesterday that because agriculture is a land-bound activity, it was necessary for people to for humans to stay at one place for a longer time. At the same time, I told you that all these things didn't happen at one particular moment. So all these processes went on evolving. I also said that it's not that agriculture evolved and immediately humans started settling, because humans they also had their cattles, and therefore there was need to look for the pastures and water and all other things for them. And so when some of the human groups were settling, some of the groups also were nomadic, or they were also wandering. But now, depending upon, because now wherever the agriculture is being practiced, it is necessary for them to stay there at that place. And then they started constructing a house. They started building a particular structure with a walls and a roof and all that. And as I said, it's not certainly the houses look like as like the modern times, but obviously they look very different because they were made up of the natural material which is available in their surroundings. Obviously, now other than protection or security, the added purpose was storage of food, a storage of food grain. At the same time, as we mentioned yesterday, the protection of the cattles, because in those days cattles used to be very important part of the life of humans and cattles and other animals, I mean, and therefore protecting them, securing them again from the external attacks. Also become important aspects. So that was also one of the important purpose. With some of these pictures yesterday, we talked about how the natural material was used in construction of the houses. So it can be grass, it can be mud, it can be bamboo sticks. The bamboo sticks used obviously in the areas where bamboo is available, I mean where bamboo is grown. But depending upon the local vegetation, you find the local vegetation also was being used. Use of stone, as we can see in this picture, with that stone is used for making a plinth. Okay, so these are some of the important characteristics that we discussed in the last class. And then I said that then on, gradually human civilization developed, And gradually, this process of settling became more and more intense. Humans started attaching themselves with the houses that they constructed, and I then said that the idea of home evolved and how house and home is different from each other. So that also we discussed yesterday. So gradually settlements were born. So from a single unit, now there is a group of units that was born, and from group of units there were number of many such groups of settlements evolved in different parts of the earth. So it led to development of hamlets and villages. I already mentioned that gradually even trade evolved, trade of food grains evolved gradually, and so from agriculture, trade and all other activities, economic activities gradually started evolving. And we know that then these hamlets and villages got transformed into a very large size of urban centers such as towns and cities and metropolises. And in this process, we find there is tremendous change in the external appearance of the houses or of the settlements. Similarly, the internal structure went on changing, and even the types of settlements, even the building material that was used also underwent a drastic change. Okay, so and yes, an added purpose is that now the settlements didn't remain only residential unit. I mean, they didn't serve only residential function, but they also started serving functions of production, functions of commerce, and etc. So gradually we have seen that how as the settlements evolve, how the purpose also went on changing. It went on widening itself from just simple physical security to more higher levels of economic functions that the settlement started carrying out. So some of these representative photographs we have seen of settlements, the rural settlement basically. And so now let us come to the discussion that we are supposed to start from today, and that is on settlement geography and its definition. Our 1.1 of the syllabus is nature, scope, and definition. So these three parts we'll try to discuss today. If time permits, we can go move ahead. Now there are some definitions on the slides. Now I want you to read these definitions carefully, because usually we have a habit, you know, that we just by heart certain definitions, a couple of them, and we write in the exam, but without, and then we don't look at it. Always remember, when you're writing an essay type answer or an assignment, see that a definition will be discussed in your answer. What the definition is talking about, what is so unique about this definition, right? Why are we talking about H.K. Stone's definition and Cohen's definition, R.L. Singh's definition? Okay, now why are we talking of these three definitions if all are talking of settlement geography, right? Now, because we are at the higher level now, okay, we are at the end of your UG years, and therefore now your overall understanding and writing and etc. Should also become advanced now. And therefore, you should know that whenever people or whenever any academician, researcher, students, when they try to define something, it is their approach and it is their understanding of the topic very much gets reflected. Okay, and many a times we have seen that these definitions have come in different time periods, and therefore, जैसे research होते जाता है, studies और ज्यादा होने लगते हैं, तो gradually the understanding of that particular topic change, and so we see a gradual evolution of definitions also over the period of time, and therefore every definition is important. Okay. So one cannot ask कि ये definition important है कि वो important है. Every definition is important because everybody has put into their idea, their approach or their understanding in it. And all we need to consider if we really want to understand that topic, now in this case settlement geography, in that case. For examination purpose, you may not write all definitions. You may select some of them. But for understanding purpose, you just cannot neglect any of them. Okay, so if you select two definitions, fine, but then don't just write those definitions and don't move away. No, Try to write a couple of lines on every definition. What is unique in that definition? So let us discuss that. I'm expecting some answers from you. So be alert and read along with me the definitions. So it's a first definition given by H.K. Stone. And H.K. Stone defines this, settlement geography as description and analysis of the distribution of buildings. Read the words carefully. Description and analysis of the distribution of buildings by which people attach themselves to the land. Description and analysis of the distribution of buildings by which people attach themselves to the land. Now think of which words from this definition are most important to understand this concept of settlement geography. So can you think of and can you tell me something? Somebody is trying to join. Right. Yes. Can I get some answers from Stone's definition? Which words are important from this entire sentence? I mean definition. Description and analysis of the distribution of buildings by which people attach themselves to the land. This is the definition. Which words are important? This is what I am asking.
Sir, I think a distribution of buildings and attach themselves to the land. These two things are important.
Correct, correct. Now you need to, you know, make a list of such keywords from all the definitions. Okay. So this is a tip to write a good answer and an assignment. That make a list of such keywords. I call them as keywords. K-E-Y. Keywords, and you can make a list of it in a rough page, and then based on all the keywords taken from all the definitions, then you can write a good paragraph overall without then referring to definition. That okay, so what is finally settlement geography? Okay, so as you rightly mentioned, that it is description and analysis. Description ka matlab hota hai ki just describing. So suppose you visited a particular place as a tourist, suppose, and then after coming back you are describing what you saw. Okay, ki kaise buildings the, roads kaise the, narrow the, wide the, tall buildings the ki smaller buildings the, multi storied the ki nahi. Okay, so uska kuch alag structure tha kya, koi purane buildings usme aapko dikhe kya jiska total structure hi completely different tha, bahut hi historical tha. So all these things then you describe in words. So description is very important. Always remember, geography particularly in its original form, when it started developing as a branch of knowledge, it developed through two important things: observation and description. People started describing, and therefore description is a very important part of any branch of knowledge. So description is important. But obviously description is not enough, because description will only give answer to the question what. Okay, so matlab I can ask you ki okay, you visited a particular place, so what did you see there? So what is answered with the help of description. But the question why, question how is not answered unless you go into the analysis of it. So analysis ka matlab kya hai, you try to find out. डिस्क्रिप्शन में आप जो है उसको डिस्क्राइब करते हो, व्हाट इज, ओके, सो यू डिस्क्राइब दैट. इन एनालिसिस यू ट्राई टू फाइंड आंसर व्हाई इट इज देयर, हाउ इट हैज डेवलप्ड और हाउ इट हैज इवॉल्वड. ओके, एंड बिकॉज वी आर ज्योग्राफर्स, द रादर वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट वी नीड टू आस्क इज वेयर इट इज लोकेटेड. ओके, बिकॉज फॉर ज्योग्राफर्स दैट डब्ल्यू इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, नो, वेयर इट इज लोकेटेड. सो वील ऑब्वियसली आस्क दैट वेयर इट इज लोकेटेड, why it is located there itself, not why not somewhere else. okay, and how that particular settlement has come up, how it has evolved over time, okay, and how it has gradually spread itself over space. So all these aspects of analysis is also an important part of settlement geography. So it is description, analysis, and obviously analysis of what? So analysis of distribution. मैंने already कहा था आपको introduct orientation के दौरान that geography is a special science and therefore we are very much interested in location of settlements and also we are interested in their distribution. What kind of distribution is? Okay. In your first year, if you remember, you have done nearest neighbor analysis in your practicals. And there you know you have studied different kinds of distribution. How distribution can be uniform, it can be random, okay, and there are different patterns also that you have studied that gradually emerge. So what is the nature of distribution of buildings in the settlement? Okay, so description, analysis, distribution, these are important words, and as you rightly pointed out, attach is very important word, which I told you in yesterday's class also, that people attach themselves. What do we mean by attach here? By attach here we mean belongingness. People feel that they belong to that particular place, okay, and from there this entire idea of insider, that is, I am insider, you know, I belong to this place, it is my place, it is my settlement or my city, my village. So these kind of concepts also develop, right? So how that attachment, how that belonging develops also is a very important part to understand settlements, because finally we are talking, we are in human geography, and we cannot discuss about settlements, you know, without humans, right? So everywhere that relationship with humans becomes important. So this is just an example, you know, that how you can, you know, describe, or I mean how you can write something on each of the definition that you are choosing to include in your answer or your assignment. Let us go ahead. Then C.F. Cohn's definition, that is study of facilities. I mean settlement geography is a study of, so I have avoided those words to, you know, avoid this crowding of the slide. So it is study of facilities men built in the process of occupying an area. Yes, somebody else now can give me keywords from Cohn's definition. Yes, don't keep quiet in the class, keep on talking. Yes, I think last definition Nishant answer. Now can anybody else tell me that?
Occupying an area.
Correct. Occupying an area. Now this is very important. So because what is settlement? Okay. So settlement is a product of, now please remember, that's why I'm asking you to write running notes, because everything is not there in the slide. Settlement is a product of settling. Settling को आप inverted comma में लिखो, okay? और settling क्या होता है, right? So as we have seen that how humans were wandering from one place to another place, and in the process they stopped at one place, okay? They stopped at one place. They started settling. They started, you know, staying at that one particular place, and gradually, and in the process, what they did, they occupied an area. So their population increased. The settlement spread होते गया. ज्यादा और ज्यादा एरिया ऑक्यूपाई करते गया, राइट? सो इट्स अ प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑक्यूपाइंग एन एरिया. अभी देखो कि हाउ ज्योग्राफी में स्पेशल पर्सपेक्टिव से कैसे अलग अलग नजरिए से देखा जाता है. स्पेशल ही अप्रोच है बट डिफरेंट है, ओके? स्टोन इज टॉकिंग अबाउट अटैचमेंट टू द लैंड, ओके? कोन इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑक्यूपाइंग एन एरिया, राइट? एंड सो दिस इज वेरी 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 यूनिक, you know, when we go deep into these definitions. And there is one more keyword, and that is facilities. Now Stone talks about buildings, well Cohn talks about facilities, okay? It means, now Cohn is indicating settlements not just as a residential unit, but settlements also as a units where there are other facilities available. Now these facilities can be of social nature, these facilities can be of economic nature, Okay, so by facilities you mean a water supply, electricity supply. So there are roads, right? There are shops. So there are other other kinds of economic activities in the area, and for that there are facilities that are made. And these facilities also don't come at one moment. You know, they also evolve very gradually, as we have seen yesterday briefly. So right. So Cohen talks about two important keywords. One is facilities, and other is process of occupying an area. Okay. Next definition. Now next definition is by R.L. Singh. Okay. अभी जो मैं स्टडी मटेरियल आपको दे दूंगा उस स्टडी मटेरियल में रहेगा कि ये स्टोन का डेफिनेशन कौन से ईयर में आया, कौन का कौन से ईयर में. ओके, एमसीक्यू जब क्वेश्चन फॉर्मेट होता है तो रिमेम्बर कि ये सारे आपके लिए ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चंस है. ओके, कि हु डिफाइन सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी एज स्टडी ऑफ फैसिलिटीज मेन बिल्ट इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑक्यूपाइंग एन एरिया, दैट इज माई क्वेश्चन. एंड आई विल गिव यू फोर ऑप्शंस. So H.K. Stone है, कौन है, आर एल सिंह है या घोषाल है. ओके, सो यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द करेक्ट वन. सो रिमेम्बर दीज आर ऑब्जेक्टिव क्वेश्चंस. ओके, या उल्टा भी पूछा जा सकता है, दैट सी एफ कौन डिफाइंड सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी एज डैश, एंड मैं नीचे चार ऑप्शन दे दूंगा, स्टडी ऑफ फैसिलिटीज, मेन बिल्ट वॉट एवर, स्टडी ऑफ प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑक्यूपेंस, डिस्क्रिप्शन. तो मैं अलग अलग चार डेफिनेशंस के जो सेंटेंस स्टेटमेंट्स है वो मैं दे दूंगा, जिसमें से आपको चूज करना है कि कौन ने क्या बताया. और एक क्वेश्चन इस पर आ सकता है कि कौन से ईयर में ये डेफिनेशन आया, जो मैंने आपको कहा कि जो स्टडी मटेरियल आपको मैं दे रहा हूं तो उसमें वो ईयर्स मेंशन है. ओके, सो स्टोन की डेफिनेशन सपोज ने 1965 में दिया, कोन का 1954 का डेफिनेशन है, तो अकॉर्डिंगली द क्वेश्चन में आस्क दैट इन विच ईयर Stone defined settlement geography as description and analysis dash dash dash. Option में रहेगा 1954, 1961, 1969 and all that. Okay? मतलब देखो, हमको दोनों तरीके से तैयारी करनी है. एक असाइनमेंट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू कि आप अपना लॉन्ग क्वेश्चन आ गया लिखने के लिए तो वो भी हमको लिखने को आना चाहिए, प्लस यदि मल्टीपल चॉइस होगा तो भी हमें आना चाहिए. इसके लिए बी अलर्ट, मेक योर रनिंग नोट्स. This is very important part. Okay, let us proceed to the third one. The third one is study of processes of occupants and the facilities like houses and the highways. Yes? Keywords?
Process of occupants and facilities.
Correct. Process of occupants and facilities. So these are two very important words. And if you now know that the process of occupants की बात CF Cohen भी करता है, facilities की बात भी CF Cohen करता है. Okay, only one point is added in this definition and that is highways. Okay, because unless you connect the settlements with each other, and don't take highways as highway in today's official terms, just consider take highways as a representative word for transport, the connections. Even within the settlement, different localities need to be connected. Okay, it can be by road, it can be by railway, whichever mode of transport. But so R.L. Singh's definition is unique because it talks about connections, which other definitions are not talking about. Always remember, humko unique dhoondna hai ki kya different hai ye definition mein. Okay, कि ये डेफिनेशन हमने क्यों दिया, जब ही कोन का भी डेफिनेशन ऑक्यूपेंस की बात करता है, फैसिलिटीज की बात करता है, तो व्हाई दिस डेफिनेशन इज बीइंग टेकन, बिकॉज़ आरएल सिंह्स डेफिनेशन बेसिकली टॉक्स अबाउट कनेक्शंस, बिकॉज़ ही मेंशन द वर्ड हाईवेज. ओके, एंड अनलेस सेटलमेंट्स आर कनेक्टेड विद ईच अदर, इफ सेटल विद द एरियाज विद इन द सेटलमेंट्स आर कनेक्टेड विद ईच अदर, ओके, द सेटलमेंट विल नॉट इमर्ज एज अ यूनिट. ओके, एंड देयरफॉर this word highway is extremely important from R.L. Singh's definition. Okay, let us see two more definitions. ये सारे definitions आपको assignment में लिखने का जरूरत नहीं है. You know, you can select some two or three of it. But MCQ के लिए everything you have to consider for multiple choice question. The next definition is by Ghoshal, G.S. Ghoshal, and that is in 1972. Let us see what G.S. Ghoshal says. He says that Settlement geography is a study of spatial variations in the process of settling and their manifestation on the land surface. Batao. Yes, keyword from Ghosal's definition. Study of spatial variations in the process of settling and their manifestation on the land surface. Yes, Aman, Dipesh. Anybody else?
Spatial variation.
Correct, spatial variation, obviously. Is there any other word which we haven't discussed in earlier definitions?
Manifestation.
Manifestation, correct. Now, ये बहुत important words है. Spatial variations भी और manifestation भी. अभी पहले जो definitions हमने देखे, पहले तीन, उसमें description की बात हुई है. डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन की बात हुई और प्रोसेस की बात हुई, राइट? कि डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सेटलमेंट का कैसे होता है और प्रोसेस ऑफ सेटलिंग ऑक्यूपेंस क्या होता है, फैसिलिटीज के बारे में भी बात हुई, ओके? लेकिन वेरिएशन के बारे में बात नहीं हुई. इसके लिए जीएस गोसाल्स डेफिनेशन इज एक्सट्रीमली इंपॉर्टेंट एंड आई ऑलवेज फील दैट यू मस्ट टेक हिज डेफिनेशन, यू मस्ट चूज हिज डेफिनेशन टू इंक्लूड इन योर आंसर, ओके? Because spatial variation is very important for geographers to understand. What is spatial variation? That how settlements vary. Vary ka spelling hai V-A-R-Y. So how settlements vary from place to place, from region to region. Okay. Why difference? What is the difference? How settlements say in the Deccan Plateau? How settlements in the Deccan Plateau are different than the settlements in the Himalayan region, or how the settlements in the Ganga plain is different than the settlements on the coastal plain. So what is the difference between these, and again why this difference comes up, okay? So ye jo spatial variation hota hai, variation matlab do alag alag jagahon pe jo settlements hai unme farak kya hai, okay? Unme kya differences hai, similarity bhi ho sakti hai. तो क्या सिमिलैरिटी है, क्या डिफरेंसेस है, वो क्यों है, व्हाई दैट सिमिलैरिटी, व्हाई दैट डिफरेंसेस. सो वी नीड टू आंसर दीज क्वेश्चंस, ओके? सो इट इज नॉट जस्ट लोकेशन. अभी देखो कैसे एक-एक फैसेट ऐड होते जा रहा है अपने अंडरस्टैंडिंग में, कि हम लोकेशन को स्टडी करते हैं, हम डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन को स्टडी करते हैं, हम प्रोसेस को स्टडी करते हैं, हम वेरिएशन को भी स्टडी करते हैं, एंड ऑल दीज ओवर इन टर्म्स ऑफ space, okay? And another thing is their manifestation on the land. What is manifestation? Okay, so manifestation is that finally how they occur, you know, how they display themselves, okay? Manifestation la apan marathi madhe kiwa hindi madhe apan ek avishkar manu shakto, you know, ki finally how it looks, okay? How they display themselves, okay? How the spatial variations are displayed, you know, so how they look like. And then we take the help of some Google satellite images and aerial photographs, you know, to understand वो कैसे दिखते हैं, क्योंकि उसमें भी हमें पता चलता है कि उनके अलग अलग फॉर्म्स है, अलग अलग टाइप्स है, अलग अलग पैटर्न है. कोई सेटलमेंट लीनियर है, कोई सेटलमेंट टी शेप है, कोई सेटलमेंट सी शेप है, ओके? कुछ सेटलमेंट प्लेन एरिया में है, इसके लिए बहुत फैला हुआ है, स्प्रेड आउट है. कोई सेटलमेंट किसी आईलैंड पे है तो उसका डेवलपमेंट जो है या स्प्रेड जो है उसको काफी लिमिटेशंस है बिकॉज इट इज ऑन द आइलैंड. सो देयर आर डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ स्पेशल मैनिफेस्टेशंस एंड फ्रॉम दैट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू गोसाल्स डेफिनेशन इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इट टॉक्स अबाउट स्पेशल वेरिएशन एंड मैनिफेस्टेशन. ओके, नाउ लेट अस टेक द लास्ट डेफिनेशन बाय आरसी शर्मा. आरसी शर्मा सेज दैट सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी इज अ स्टडी दैट aims to analyze the size, the form, function, and regional association of human settlements and traces their growth and pattern of distribution. This is by R.C. Sharma. Now it's very long, it's longer definition than other definitions that we discussed, and then it has many keywords, right? The first keyword is obviously size, form, function. Okay, so settlement study क्या क्या study करता है, settlement के कौन से aspect study होते हैं settlement geography में, size of a settlement, whether size is large or small, okay, और इतना देख के चुप नहीं बैठना है, उसको answer करना है, why, for everything one has to question why, okay, because that only will lead to a better understanding of it, okay, so why, where, how, okay, मतलब okay, large settlement है, small settlement है, ऐसा बोल के नहीं होगा, हमको ये question पूछना पड़ेगा, where the large size settlements are located, okay, is location is a factor responsible for their large size or small size, okay, how a settlements become large in size, or why the settlement growth remained limited, why settlement growth remained smaller, okay, and not larger. So we need to answer these questions, okay, form of settlement, okay, settlement ka shape kya hai, settlement ka internal structure kya hai, function kya hai. बिकॉज हमको मालूम है, हम कभी कभी कहते हैं ना कि ये सिटी इंडस्ट्रियल सिटी है, एक सिटी एजुकेशनल सिटी है, कोई कमर्शियल सिटी है, कोई टूरिस्ट सेंटर है, तो ये अलग अलग फंक्शन सेटलमेंट के जो होते हैं उसका भी स्टडी सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी में होता है. रीजनल एसोसिएशन की बात अभी कुछ हद तक हमने की जब हमने स्पेशल वेरिएशन के बारे में कहा कि हाउ अ पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ सेटलमेंट इज एसोसिएटेड विद अ पर्टिकुलर रीजन. अगदी छोटा एग्जाम्पल देतो, वेरी स्मॉल एग्जाम्पल, यू हैव स्टडीड इन योर स्कूल ज्योग्राफी, व्हेन यू टॉक्ड अबाउट आई थिंक थर्ड और फोर्थ स्टैंडर्ड, व्हेन यू टॉक्ड अबाउट हाउसेस इन डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ महाराष्ट्र इन योर स्कूल ज्योग्राफी, एंड यू मेंशन, एंड इफ यू रिमेंबर, यू हैव सेड दैट इन द कोंकण रीजन, इन द कोस्टल महाराष्ट्र रीजन, द हाउसेस हैव स्लैंटिंग रूफ्स, द रूफ ऑफ द हाउसेस इज स्लैंटिंग, इट इज नॉट फ्लैट. Okay, where in the coastal areas, in Konkan region of Maharashtra. While if you go to the Desh area of Maharashtra, or as we call it as plateau area of Maharashtra, we usually find that the roof of the houses is flat. It is not slanting. Okay, now do you remember why it is so? Which you have studied in school geography? Tell me.
So because of the rain.
Exactly, because of the rainfall. Heavy rainfall make it necessary to have a slanting roof so that rainwater will not get stored, okay, and rather it will move down along that slanting roof. While on the Desh region we find that there is lesser rainfall, and that's the reason why the roofs are flat. Obviously, now you if you go, the things are changed, like, so because over time period, no, बहुत बदलाव आ जाता है बहुत सारे चीजों में. लेकिन जस्ट याद दिलाना था कि स्कूल ज्योग्राफी में आपने ये पढ़ा हुआ था, राइट? सो ये इसकी मैं बात कर रहा हूँ रीजनल एसोसिएशन की, बिकॉज़ वो हाउसेस कोस्टल एरिया में है, बारिश ज्यादा है, तो इसके लिए उधर हमको स्लांटिंग रूफ्स मिलते हैं. तो ये हो गया उसका एसोसिएशन रीजन के साथ. ऐसे हम रीजनल एसोसिएशन लगा सकते हैं विथ रेफरेंस टू द साइज, विथ रेफरेंस टू फॉर्म, विथ रेफरेंस टू फंक्शंस. Okay, so that becomes extremely important. Similarly, settlement geography also traces their growth. Main hamesha kehta hu, last time bhi aapko bataya tha, everything is connected with everything. You cannot say ki hum geographer hai to hum kyun history ki baat kare, growth se hamara kya sambandh. Okay, so we cannot say like that, because we just cannot separate out these things. Okay, so one also has to understand how settlements grow, or how settlements evolved, how they grew in the due course of time, and gradually how they distribute. Koi bhi kaun sa bhi settlement suddenly large karke paida nahi hota, okay, wo hamesha chhota hi settlement hota hai, gradually badhte jata hai, grow hote jata hai. Abhi sare settlement grow nahi hote jate, koi waise ke waise chote hi reh jate hain, okay, to ye jo unke alag alag aspects hai growth ke, okay, तो वो भी हमको देखना बहुत जरूरी होता है. सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी ये भी स्टडी करता है ग्रोथ एंड पैटर्न ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. सो इफ यू लुक एट आरसी शर्मास डेफिनेशन, देन देयर आर सो मेनी keywords that we get from this definition. I repeat, size, form, function, regional association, growth and pattern of distribution. Okay, तो यदि हमने ये overall सारे definition, okay, तो कौन से हम एक repeat करता हूँ मैं कि आप देखो कि आपने notebook में सब कुछ enter किया है क्या? Okay, हमने देखा कि description and analysis, okay, then we have seen distribution, attachment or belongingness, process of occupation or process of occupants, facilities, houses and highways, special variations, manifestation, size, form and function, regional association, growth, pattern of distribution. Okay, so these are all the keywords that we discussed from these five definitions. Okay, और भी कई सारे definitions है, उसमें से और भी आपको कुछ नया मिल सकता है. Every definition is new. और इसके लिए मैंने कहा कि हर एक डेफिनेशन को उन्हें उसका एक इम्पोर्टेंस देना चाहिए, बिकॉज हर एक ने अपना अपना अप्रोच, अपना अपना पर्सपेक्टिव उस डेफिनेशन में रखा है. एंड ऑल डेफिनेशंस आर इम्पोर्टेंट, ओके, बिकॉज ओनली देन वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड द सेटलमेंट इन टोटैलिटी इन अ मोर होलिस्टिक नेचर. ओके, तो सारे डेफिनेशंस में लार्जली क्या बोला गया है, तो सारे डेफिनेशंस कहते हैं कि सेटलमेंट का जो प्रोसेस होता है, सेटलमेंट का जो फॉर्म होता है और सेटलमेंट जो फंक्शंस अलग अलग करते हैं, तो ये फाइनली बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट है सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी के लिए. ओके, एंड डोंट फॉरगेट, मैं वापस ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि जब भी आप आंसर लिखते हो किसी भी असाइनमेंट का या लॉन्ग आंसर का, somebody is trying to join, just a minute. So, जब भी आप आंसर लिखते हो किसी भी असाइनमेंट का या क्वेश्चन का, देन ये जरूरी होता है कि आप हमेशा आपके दिमाग में रहना चाहिए कि मैं ज्योग्राफर हूँ और मैं ज्योग्राफी का आंसर लिख रहा हूँ. बिकॉज सोशल साइंस में बहुत प्रॉब्लम होता है, बिकॉज समटाइम्स इफ यू फॉरगेट दैट कि यू आर अ ज्योग्राफर, देन ग्रेजुअली आपका आंसर जब हम पढ़ते हैं तो लगता है कि अरे ये किसी सोशोलॉजिस्ट ने लिखा है, ये किसी इकोनॉमिस्ट ने लिखा है. इट लुक्स लाइक अ सोशियोलॉजी आंसर, इट लुक्स लाइक एन इकोनॉमिक्स आंसर. ओके, दो द टॉपिक ऑफ स्टडी नो मे बी बिलोंगिंग टू सम अदर ब्रांच ऑफ नॉलेज, बट आवर अप्रोच, आवर पर्सपेक्टिव इज ज्योग्राफिकल, दैट वी शुड नॉट फॉरगेट. ओके, और ज्योग्राफिकल पर्सपेक्टिव मतलब क्या आ गया, लोकेशन, ओके, डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, देन आस्किंग क्वेश्चंस वेयर, व्हाई, हाउ, finding out the regional associations, special variations, okay, the size and form and pattern, morphology, and all these things come in picture. Pattern, obviously, the trend and growth, all these aspects become extremely important. अभी हम पूरे syllabus में जो इस साल पढ़ने वाले हैं settlement geography का, ये settlements के जो भी aspects अभी हमने जो कि भी keywords हमने देखे, तो ये सारे हम पढ़ने वाले हैं अपने पूरे सिलेबस में. सिलेबस का कॉपी आपके पास है, यू कैन ऑलवेज सी दैट. सो दीज आर ऑल डेफिनेशंस. नाउ लेट अस ट्राई टुगेदर अगेन, यू नो, टू अंडरस्टैंड. आई होप यू कैन सी दिस पिक्चर ऑन द स्लाइड. नाउ कैन समवन टेल मी दैट व्हाट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ दिस इमेज. लेट अस से जब आपने ये इमेज देखा तो इमीडिएटली फट से आपने पहले चीज कौन सी ऑब्जर्व की, क्या कोई बता सकता है?
ऑक्सबो लेक,
वेरी करेक्ट. ओके, रादर इट इज अ मियांडर. ओके, ऑक्सबो लेक डेवलप नहीं हुआ है, बट इट इज अ मियांडर बेसिकली, बट यू आर वेरी क्लोज. ओके, नाउ ये मियांडर के वजह से कुछ स्पेसिफिक शेप मिला है क्या वेजिटेशन को? सी द वेजिटेशन अलोंग द बैंक्स.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What kind of shape it is? How can you describe it?
Sir, like a horseshoe.
Okay. Like a horseshoe. Correct. Can we also call it as C-shape? Alphabet C. Yes. It is C-shape. Okay. And you can see a very interesting. Matlab, now you understand ki how, matlab, aapne meander padha geomorphology mein, first year mein. Okay. Aur abhi hum वही मियांडर वापस डिस्कस कर रहे हैं इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ सेटलमेंट. Okay, so it is the landform that is one of the important factor, you know, that provide that morphology, that provide that shape or form to the settlement. Okay, and anything else you observe in the inner and outer loop of the meander? If you have forgotten, ये बीच वाला जो एरिया है, we call it as the inner loop, while this is the outer loop, ये जो बाहर का है वो. So this is the outer loop. कोई difference है क्या इसमें outer loop में और inner loop में?
In the inner loop, vegetation has developed, or in the outer loop, settlement is there.
Exactly. Any reason why it is so? Can anybody think of why it is so? Why no settlements in the inner loop?
Sir, because I think there is a possibility of the water seeping and there is a risk of losing their housing.
Yes. Okay. Because it's a inner loop, there is a possibility that during heavy rainfall, the area can get flooded. Okay, so there is always a danger, you know, of very existence. Another important thing is the land in the inner areas is very fertile. Okay, don't forget basic geomorphology, jo aapne padha tha, the geomorphology of the meander. Because can you observe along the inner belts that there is sandy deposition at the edge along the banks? Can you observe
yes,
this?
Yes, yes, sir.
This one? This you can very clearly observe the sandy deposition, and look at the opposite bank, you don't find that kind of a sandy deposition. Okay, now this is I don't go back to our FY geomorphology, but you very well know that why it takes occurs. Okay, so you can see that the areas in the inner loop are basically used for agriculture. Okay, you can very clearly see those agricultural farms. Okay, in the inner loop, okay, so water is available because of this river, as well as the fertile soil is available in the region. While on the outside, on the outer loop, you can see there is lot of development of settlement. So you can see settlements here on the in the outer loop. Okay, you can see settlements here also. Okay, so you can see one small settlement here also. Okay, so there is a development of settlement here. Now, if you can, यदि आप मेरा this arrow यदि cursor मेरा देख सकते हो, तो मैं एक particular area को point out कर रहा हूँ, settlement को. तो ये एक settlement है. Okay, to your bottom left of the photograph, I mean foreground of the left foreground of the photograph. Can you describe its shape? Because this is not C shape. Can somebody describe this one? नहीं समझ रहे? Now this, if you see, it is more in a kind of a straighter line. ये थोड़ा सा straighter line में है, right? Okay. तो अभी हो सकता है अभी अपने पास उतना ही पार्ट है फोटोग्राफ का, एंड वी आर गोइंग टू सी लॉट ऑफ फोटोग्राफ्स इन दिस थ्रू आउट द ईयर. ओके, सो अंडरस्टैंड हाउ अ लीनियर सेटलमेंट लुक्स लाइक. सो दिस इज मोर अ लीनियर सेटलमेंट बिकॉज इट इज स्ट्रेट, नो, इट इज लोकेटेड अलोंग द रोड दैट इज पासिंग बाय इन बिटवीन. ओके, एंड वी विल सी मेनी सच फोटोग्राफ्स ऑफ डिफरेंट पैटर्न्स. दिस इज हाउ when we get a photograph, when we get a image, you know, we can interpret it. Okay, we should start with the most striking feature, jaise humne meander lake ko pakad ke shuru kiya, and then we started talking about settlements with reference to that. We also talked about agriculture with reference to that. Okay, so this is how images, photographs are very important tools to study settlement geography. In our paper 9, we have an practical on interpretation of aerial photographs. Okay, so in a way we also started with that. Okay, so ये आपका practical होने वाला है कि आपको इस तरीके के photographs, I mean aerial photographs मिलेंगे, और जिसको आपको interpret करना है, striking feature find out करना है, क्या major geography point of view कौन से features है, ये भी आपको उसमें लिखना है. Okay, so we will in between, in throughout the presentation, we will make reference to, we will take up such photographs and we'll try to understand, we'll try to interpret them. So aapko automatic wo bhi ek practice ho jayega, aerial photo interpretation. Okay, so now that we have seen nature, definitions of settlement geography, let us now talk about the nature and scope of settlement geography. Okay, now abhi ye nature and scope, ye words apne itne baar suna hai, because in many subjects, you know, every paper start with this, you know, nature and scope, like that. But have we ever thought of ki nature ka matlab kya, scope ka matlab kya? बिकॉज मेनी टाइम्स मैं तो देखता हूँ कि एक बच्चा जो नेचर में लिखता है वही कंटेंट किसी दूसरे बच्चे के स्कोप में होता है. ओके, इन बुक्स ऑल्सो समटाइम्स देर इज लॉट ऑफ वेरिएशन. ओके, सो वाई इट इज सो? सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू शुड नो अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज नेचर एंड वॉट इज स्कोप, सो दैट इट बिकम्स ईजियर फॉर अस टू राइट. अभी हमको ये बहुत ही आसान होने वाला है नेचर एंड स्कोप, क्योंकि हमने डेफिनेशन बहुत डिटेल में डिस्कस किया, जिसमें ऑलरेडी उसका नेचर और स्कोप का रेफरेंस हमने ले लिया है. ओके, सो नेचर का मतलब क्या है? व्हाट इज नेचर ऑफ अ सब्जेक्ट? नेचर का मतलब होता है सैलिएंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, बेसिक फीचर्स ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट. जैसे हम इस नेचर, इस वर्ड को हम नेचर ऑफ अ पर्सन करके भी यूज करते हैं, जैसे किसी पर्सन का स्वभाव कैसा है. तो नेचर का मतलब इधर है कि सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी का स्वभाव कैसा है, उसका कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स क्या है, कौन से डिस्टिंग्विशिंग कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इस सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी के हैं. ओके, तो उसको हम नेचर कहते हैं. और स्कोप का मतलब क्या होता है? स्कोप का मतलब होता है कि सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी का सब्जेक्ट मैटर क्या है, क्या क्या इंक्लूड करता है वो, उसका स्कोप क्या है. मराठी मध्ये आपण एक शब्द वापरतो आवाका, की त्याचा आवाका काय आहे, what is included in it, okay, and what will be included in future. Okay, ki pehle wala scope kaise tha, abhi scope kya hai, future mein uska scope kya hone wala hai. So what are new things that are being added? So scope basically talks about what is studied in that particular subject, while nature basically talks about the very swabhav, the very characteristics, features of that particular subject. So let us see what are those characteristics or features of settlement geography. Okay, some of these are very simple, some of these we already know, so I will just refer to them. First is, all of us know that settlement geography is a sub branch of human geography. Okay, all of us know that geography is broadly divided into physical geography and human geography, and human geography is then further divided into number of other branches, while settlement geography is one of them. ओके, इसको कहते हैं कि हम जो सब्जेक्ट को या जो जो ब्रांच को स्टडी कर रहे हैं उसको हमको सिचुएट करना पड़ता है, लोकेट करना. वेयर योर सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी इज लोकेटेड, सो इट इज विद इन द फ्रेमवर्क ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, सो इट इज अ ब्रांच, सब ब्रांच ऑफ ह्यूमन ज्योग्राफी. सिमिलरली, सो सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी इज बोथ, सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी इज अ सोशल साइंस, settlement geography is also a special science. Okay, it is a social science because it is connected with humans, and because it is a social science, it is inherently interdisciplinary. ye bhulna nahi hai. Okay, hum jab morphology padhenge, house ka structure wagera dekhenge, tab hum baat karenge ki kaise religion and other aspects, social characteristic, it can be gender, how it affects the morphology, how it affects the internal structure of houses. Okay, so you will find that when we talk about settlement geography, we cannot just concentrate ourselves on space or spatial aspects per se, but we also have to consider the aspects from other social sciences. क्योंकि हम settlement की function की बात करते हैं, मतलब उधर economics आ गया. Okay, हम settlement के form और उसकी बात करते हैं जब आप ये जब दी सोशियोलॉजी का रेफरेंस आता है. ओके, हम प्लान्ड सेटलमेंट की बात करते हैं, मतलब पॉलिसी का सवाल आता है कि गवर्नमेंट पॉलिसी सेटलमेंट ग्रोथ को कैसा अफेक्ट करती है, तो हम पॉलिटिकल साइंस को रेफर कर रहे हैं. ओके, राइट, हम अटैचमेंट की हमने बात की. ओके, दैट हाउ ह्यूमंस आर अटैच्ड टू देयर सेटलमेंट्स, okay, then you will find it is, then we are more looking into behavior and psychology. So looking at it from behavioral geography point of view. So there are a number of ways in which, you know, settlements are connected with it. And I mean, it is connected with climate. It is connected with the local geology. What kind of stones are used in house, in constructing houses depends upon the local geology. Okay. So there are the interdisciplinary ka matlab kya hai ki settlement geography dusre kai sare sciences ke saath juda hua hai. Okay, not just social sciences, even also with natural sciences. Okay, so it is very much interdisciplinary in nature. Abhi jab aap assignment mein ye likhoge to ye settlement geography is a social science, itna line ek likh ke nahi hoga. Abhi jo main describe karne ki koshish kar raha hu, ye aap describe karoge, आप भी कुछ आपके एग्जांपल्स उसमें डालोगे कि कैसे सोशल, कैसे सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी हिस्ट्री के साथ जुड़ा हुआ है, कैसे इकोनॉमिक्स के साथ जुड़ा हुआ है, एक्सेट्रा. सो दैट यू विल ट्राई टू ऐड. नो डाउट सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी इज अ स्पेशल साइंस बिकॉज इट्स अ पार्ट एंड पार्सल ऑफ ज्योग्राफी. एंड जस्ट नाउ व्हाइल डिस्कसिंग डेफिनेशंस वी हैव सीन दैट हाउ सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी इज लोकेशन स्पेसिफिक, हाउ इट स्टडीज डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन, डेंसिटी पैटर्न्स, regional variations, regional associations. Sorry. So these aspects we already have studied. Next is settlement geography is a dynamic sub-branch. What is dynamic? ये बच्चों को कभी कभी particular word confusing होता है. Dynamic का simple मतलब है changing. So dynamic is changing. Changing like changing कैसे? Changing over space and changing over time. Okay, so this is very important. Matlab how over time settlements have changed. Jab matlab ancient period mein settlement kaisa tha, medieval period mein kaisa tha, abhi kaisa hai modern mein. Aap alag alag tarike se usko discuss kar sakte hain. Matlab in terms of India, pre-colonial, post-colonial, alag alag nazariye se usko dekh sakte hain ki over the period of time how settlements changed. Okay. And also over space, how settlements are different from one region to another, what is the similarity, what are the differences, why those similarities and differences come up. Okay, so if even when you are traveling from one place to another place, we can see that the settlements are changing over space. Okay, then the role of socio-economic factors in it. Okay, is it that religion affects the kind of religion affects the internal structure of the house? Okay, is caste anyway related to it, related to the morphology or the internal structure of the house? Okay, is the economic level, the rich and poor, is it so that the settlement will also exhibit that the differences in the economic standards of people staying in that area? So a lot of things are affecting settlements, and that is making the settlements very dynamic. So settlement geography bhi dynamic ho gaya kyunki wo dynamic object ko study kar raha hai. Okay, jo abhi humne definition mein bhi dekha ki jo ki jis geographer ko 1954 mein aisa laga ki settlement geography aisa hai, to kisi dusre geographer ko 1980 mein laga ki nahi settlement geography aisa hai. Okay, because beech mein kuch badlav aa gaya hai, naya research hua hai. Okay, so accordingly there is a change. Right now this photograph I always show to students. Okay, abhi kya bata sakte ho aap ki isme kya khas baat hai, what is so different in this, striking feature kya hai? last photo mein aapne meander kaha, iska striking picture, striking feature kya hai, koi bata sakta hai? Yes. Guess करो, गलत हुआ तो चलेगा. ऐसी कौन सी खास बात है इस फोटोग्राफ में? Yes,
sir. Like a crowded urban or a metropolitan area.
Okay, number one is crowded, correct. anything else, but that is not I am looking at. But you are not wrong also. Observe it carefully.
Buildings and slums.
Exactly. Buildings and slums. So you can see that अभी हमने तो कहा कि कैसे सेटलमेंट चेंज होता है एक जगह पे और दूसरे जगह पे. अभी इधर तो एक ही जगह का सेटलमेंट है. दिस इज वन सेटलमेंट एट वन प्लेस. बट विद इन दैट यू सी देयर इज लॉट ऑफ वेरिएशन दैट वन कैन ऑब्जर्व. ओके, लॉट ऑफ वेरिएशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ द इकोनॉमिक स्टैंडर्ड. ओके, इस फोटो का बैकग्राउंड देखो तो जरा. This is the background of the photograph. This is the foreground of the photograph. This is the middle ground of the photograph. This is how we look at. हम उसको aerial photo में जाएंगे तब पढ़ेंगे. Okay? So इसका background देख लो तो. Okay? ये side पे right of the background observe करो. You can see there are tall buildings. Construction भी चालू है किसी building का. Okay? So this area में कुछ नया हो रहा है. Some renewing का process चल रहा है. Okay? बहुत सारा वेजिटेशन है किसी पर्टिकुलर एरिया में. ओके, सब मीडियम साइज बिल्डिंग्स भी है सामने मिडिल ग्राउंड में, पीछे बहुत ही टॉल बिल्डिंग्स भी है. लेकिन इफ यू सी द फोरग्राउंड यू कैन सी दिस एंटायर एरिया इज इन एब्सोल्यूट स्लम्स. ओके, नाउ दिस पर्टिकुलर शो द काइंड ऑफ इनइक्वालिटी दैट एग्जिस्ट इन द सेटलमेंट. ओके, वेयर द रिच एंड पुअर बोथ कोएग्जिस्ट. ओके, and it certainly talk about the inequalities, the intra-urban inequality, that is jo inequality within the city hum observe karte hain. Okay, so where there are upper class, middle class, lower class people, economic terms I'm saying, are staying together. Okay, so the most striking feature of these photographs is this difference of building as well as slums which coexist together. Okay, सो ये सारे चीजें हम सेटलमेंट में पढ़ते हैं. इसके वजह से सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग बन जाता है, डायनामिक बन जाता है. ओके, इन आवर अंडरस्टैंडिंग सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी इज आल्सो अ सिस्टमैटिक साइंस. सिस्टमैटिक मतलब एक स्टेप बाय स्टेप स्टडी उस सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी का हो सकता है. ओके, सो वी यूजुअली स्टार्ट विद, हम सडनली पैटर्न क्या है क्वेश्चन नहीं पूछते. पहले हम देखते हैं कि ओके उसका लोकेशन किधर है, उसका ओरिजिन कैसे हुआ, उसका ग्रोथ कैसे हुआ, देन हम उसके कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स देखते हैं, बाद में उसको क्लासिफाई करके हम टाइप स्टडी करते हैं. सो देयर इज अ सिस्टमैटिक वे ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग द पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट ऑफ सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी. देयर इज अनदर एंगल टू इट, दैट इज इफ यू लुक एट सेटलमेंट एज अ पार्ट ऑफ सिस्टम और द सिस्टम अप्रोच. ओके, देन वी कैन ऑल्सो लुक एट सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी अकॉर्डिंगली, वेयर every settlement is systemically related with other settlement. Okay, ye thoda difficult part hai, ye thoda hum baad mein apne syllabus mein dekhenge. Filhal main itna hi just bol ke chhod raha hu. Next is settlement geography is comparatively new branch. Okay, iska matlab as a branch settlement geography evolved relatively later as compared to some other branches of ज्योग्राफी. इट डजंट मीन कि सेटलमेंट का स्टडी हमने बहुत लेट चालू किया. ओके, सेटलमेंट का स्टडी पहले से ही है, लेकिन सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी करके एक जो ब्रांच है, एक इंडिपेंडेंट ब्रांच. ओके, तो ये जो प्रोसेस है ये थोड़ा सा ये लेट प्रोसेस हुआ या रिलेटिवली लेटर डेवलपमेंट है. ओके, this is too late, Kusum joining at the end of the lecture almost. Okay, now you should not forget that in 1899 settlement geography was more considered or more projected in terms of as a separate branch of geography, and it was O. Schluter, okay, who did that this particular task. So O. Schluter is called as the father of settlement geography in 1899. Similarly, there are many French and German geographers who contributed to the development of settlement geography, such as Jean Brunches, Walter Christoller, American geographers like Richard Hartshorne, Indian geographers like Patrick Geddes contributed exhaustively to the development of settlement geography. There are many other geographers, these are just few names. Okay, but I need not tell you now that objective questions hai isme, jaise O. Schluter who is the father of settlement geography, okay, or in which year O. Schluter did the work. So many such objective MCQ type of questions can come on such points. Okay, another important aspect of nature is that settlement geography is settlement centered geography, which is obviously, that's why we call it a settlement geography. Matlab, उसका हमने पूछा कि सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी का यूनिट ऑफ स्टडी क्या है, तो सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी का यूनिट ऑफ स्टडी है सेटलमेंट. तो सेटलमेंट इटसेल्फ इज अ यूनिट ऑफ स्टडी. ओके, तो इट इज नेसेसरी कि हम सेटलमेंट्स का मतलब क्या है ये भी जान ले, जो कि हम नेक्स्ट टॉपिक में करने ही वाले हैं. ओके, लेकिन इसके लिए मैं सिर्फ इधर रीड करके छोड़ देता हूँ, हम ये भी डेफिनेशन डिटेल में पढ़ेंगे जब हम 1.2 में जाएंगे. ओके, तो सेटलमेंट का मतलब क्या है, तो सेटलमेंट जैसे मैंने कहा, सेटलमेंट इज ए प्रोडक्ट ऑफ, आई होप ये आपने लिख के रखा है, ये नहीं है स्लाइड पे, सेटलमेंट इज अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द प्रोसेस ऑफ सेटलिंग. व्हाट आई एम रिपीटिंग, प्रोसेस, सेटलमेंट इज ए प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द प्रोसेस ऑफ सेटलिंग. ओके, तो हमेशा आप प्रोसेस प्रोडक्ट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से देखो ना कि कौन सा प्रोडक्ट है, कौन सी प्रोसेस है. अर्बनाइजेशन इज अ प्रोसेस, अर्बन इज अ प्रोडक्ट. ओके, सो सेटलमेंट इज अ प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द प्रोसेस ऑफ सेटलिंग. तो इट इज कनेक्टेड विद प्रोसेसेस ऑफ सेटलिंग, प्रोसेसेस ऑफ ऑक्यूपाइंग, प्रोसेसेस ऑफ ड्वेलिंग एक्सेट्रा. ओके, नाउ देयर आर वेरियस पीपल हु हैव डिफाइंड सेटलमेंट्स इन अ डिफरेंट वे. सो सुमना घोष defined settlement as a collection of man-made structures put up with the intention of habitation or socio-economic use, which forms a special unit of human interaction. While R.L. Singh defines settlement as an occupants unit that represents an organized colony of human beings, including the buildings in which they live or work, or store or use them otherwise, and the tracks or streets over which their movement take place. So these settlements are very important because that is the unit of study for settlement geography. Hum yahi definition sab 1.2 mein detail mein discuss karne wale hain. Okay, so settlement can be looked at as a unit. Settlement as a with the term in terms of the plan of the settlement, the morphology of the settlement, the architecture of the settlement, the relation, its relation with nature. Okay, or settlement can be considered as a part of the system. So isme concepts aa gaye, ranking, hierarchy, classification, or you can also look at settlement as a part of larger landscape. Okay, so what is the impact of other factors on settlement, what is the impact of settlement on other aspects, other elements of the landscape. So from this point of view, मतलब सेटलमेंट को भी अलग अलग परस्पेक्टिव से देखा जा सकता है, एज अ यूनिट, एज अ सिस्टम, एज अ लैंडस्केप एक्सेट्रा. ये सारे चीजें अपने सिलेबस में आने वाली है एज वी प्रोसीड. सिमिलरली जैसे हर एक ब्रांच के अपने अपने ब्रांचेस होते हैं, सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी के भी ब्रांचेस है, दो ब्रॉड ब्रांचेस है, अर्बन सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी एंड रूरल सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी. ओके, urban settlement geography talks more about urban, while rural settlement geography talks more about rural. So one is focusing more on the urban settlement, while the other focuses more on the rural settlements. Now if you remember in our FYBA, we studied this concept of rural urban dichotomy. What is dichotomy? That is considering rural and urban as two completely different entities. जैसे आप ये फोटो में देख रहे हो, रूरल बिल्कुल अलग दिखता है, अर्बन बिल्कुल अलग दिखता है. As if both are dichotomous to each other, both are completely contradiction to each other. ये हो गया dichotomy का approach. ये last point देखो, from dichotomy to continuum. अब मैंने आपको उस time FY में ही बताया था कि it is not very good to look at settlements from a dichotomy point of view, rather it becomes more important to look at settlement from the point of view of continuum. What is continuum? Continuum here is continuity. It is rural that gradually gets transformed into urban. So looking it as a process, okay, matlab right side ka picture ekdam chakachak dikh raha hai urban wala, लेकिन हिस्ट्री में पास्ट में कभी ना कभी ये ऐसा नहीं था, राइट? इट यूज टू बी सेमी अर्बन, सेमी रूरल, रूरल, ओके, एंड देन ग्रेजुअली ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम इट हैज डेवलप्ड इनटू दिस. सो लुकिंग एट रूरल अर्बन एज कंटिन्यूम, एज अ कंटिन्यूअस प्रोसेस, ओके, एज अ पार्ट ऑफ द सेम प्रोसेस, इंस्टेड ऑफ लुकिंग एट देम एज टू डिस्टिंक्ट यूनिट, उसको कंप्लीटली अलग अलग यूनिट मान के नहीं चलना है, ओके, ये बहुत जरूरी है. सो दिस इज ऑल वॉट वी डिस्कस इन द नेचर ऑफ सेटलमेंट ज्योग्राफी.